episode 1142, Hand in Hand.
Moms, needing a little inspiration and a ray of hope? You've come to the right place. This is the show that you can turn to for just the pick-me-up you need. This is Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy day. How is your weekend going? Today is Sweet Spirit Sunday, and it is a time of reflection, a time to not worry about anything else, not to struggle with your mindset, not to sit here and worry about what's on your to-do list. It's all about turning inward and upward, hand in hand. That's what we're chatting about today. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, the world shows you the way to go, but when you stumble, who holds you hand in hand? Most of the time, it's you. Quick to jump up, dragging yourself off the floor of failure, fearing ridicule and disappointment. So unfair. Not right. You've been there, haven't you? Fallen and you're like, oh my gosh, who's looking? I got to tell you this story. We went to go down south to Alabama to visit my oldest daughter's boyfriend. They were having family day. He's going through flight school and flight training. And so it opened, you know, they open up their doors to allow family to come in. And we went down there, drove down. There's about 6 hours from where we are now. But before we got on the trip, I had to gas up, right? Gas is very important. If you don't have fuel in the tank, you can't get anywhere. So my hubby and our two youngest boys decided to go in at the gas station to go get some drinks. And my daughter was, which is our number three of the five, because we have five children. So little Ashley's in the car with our puppy dog, Rhino, and holding down the fort in there. And I'm, you know, filling up the gas tank. And you know how the gas, you know, you put it in and then you've got that little wonderful hose that's connected to the actual, you know, tank itself. And so it's connected to your car in the tank. Well, I was on the backside of it and I needed to cross over and it was just kind of dirty. We had had lots of rain and things were happening and there was mud and I just didn't want to go around and there was another car that had just pulled up, didn't want to interfere in their space, etc. So I decided I would go over the hose. So I went and tried to go over the hose, yet my back foot got caught on the hose and whoom, down I fell. And I fell pretty hard. And my daughter, when she was watching me, little did I know she was watching me, but she just started laughing. When we fall down, we're quick to get back up. I don't know how fast I jumped up, but I figured every security camera was on me. And eventually when they watch that footage, they are going to be rolling in their seats. That's what happens to us when we fall, right? We're worried about who's looking on us. There's cameras everywhere. Eyes are everywhere. We may end up on a social media post somewhere and we had no idea we were even there, yet we were there. But somebody else was watching more. It's so unfair, isn't it? The world promises comfort and guidance only to leave you empty-handed when you fall. Now you're stuck with anxiety, depression, frustration, and loneliness. Maybe a little anger there too. Yet hand in hand, you're not alone. Gently, God reaches for you. Desperately, you either run away or you grab him hand in hand. Don't bury yourself in shame because of what the world projects onto you. We do it. It's easy to fall into the world's trap. Because we want their acceptance. We want to know that we are good in their eyes, the world's eyes, however the world society defines it at that particular time, because you know it changes every minute. You're either great on social media and you're getting all these wonderful, you know, accolades and people love you, or you're getting slammed because for whatever reason, it doesn't matter. Don't bury yourself in shame because of what the world projects on you. Go hand in hand with the Lord. And I think for most of us, we fall short of that. It's not how many times we've fallen and we can't get back up. It's that we've fallen and we choose to stay there and not allow God to be there for us. Think about how it feels to interlock, holding hands, receiving comfort, love, acceptance, confidence, safety, and hope. It's an embrace worthy of you. Psalm 37, verse 24 says, though they stumble, they will never fall, for the Lord holds them by the hand. Hand in hand. God does not leave you in this world helpless and hopeless. Yeah, you could be standing at the gas station, tripping over the stupid hose, fall down, hurt both of your palms of your hand. You don't know what happened, but man, you're quick to jump up thinking you can do everything on your own, yet you know someone else is watching, and God's standing there going, hello, what about me? And he gently is reaching out his hand. Here I am. Here I am. God sent his only begotten son for you so he can hold your hand. He delights in holding you tightly, embracing you lovingly. It's the heavenly touch, the Lord hand in hand. What is your schedule like this week? How many falls are you going to take? How many security cameras and how many eyes are going to be on you? Are you going to fail? Are you going to be quick to jump up so people aren't laughing and ridiculing you and you're sitting there in utter disbelief and disappointment in yourself? Falling into the traps of what the world sets? That's not living a full, beautiful life that God has designed for you. He's outstretching his arm to you, his hand, hand in hand, he says, here I am. So this week, when the days are longer than the moments you experience, reach out as God is with you, hand in hand. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.